In Julia, you can create functions that can take another function as an argument. In the coding world, a function that takes one or more functions as arguments is known as a higher order function. In many cases, when using a higher order function, it doesn't make sense to take the time to declare and define a new function just to use it once as an argument in some other function. In those cases, it's handy to use something called an anonymous function, which is a function that doesn't have a name. Let's take a look at an example. I'm in VS Code, and I've already created a new .jl file. I've also launched the Julia REPL by using Alt-J, then Alt-O. In addition, I've modified my user interface so that my REPL window takes up roughly half of my screen. Let's start by setting up a vector with three elements of type string. The map function is an example of a built-in higher order function that comes included with Julia. The first argument is a function, and the second argument is a collection. The map function applies the function to each element in the collection. The length function returns the number of elements in a collection. So in this example, the map function returns a new vector containing the number of characters in each of the three strings. Length is a built-in function provided by Julia. But what if you want to use your own custom function with a map function? Before hitting Shift-Enter, let's talk about this code. In this example, the first argument is called an anonymous function. This X before the arrow is the function argument. The expression after the arrow is the body of the function. So this syntax is a shorthand way of defining a function without using a function end block, and without using a function name, hence an anonymous function. This code will apply this anonymous function to each element in the collection. Now hit Shift-Enter to see what happens. In the REPL, you'll see a new vector where the original elements now have the word doggo added to them. So that's the basics of using an anonymous function in Julia. In the next chapter, you'll learn how to use Julia's standard library.